Hello viewers, today we shall do lesson 9 of Footprints Without Feet, that is Bholi, written by K.A. Abbas. Its main characters are Bholi, Ramlal, Bholi's father, Bholi's mother, Bholi's school teacher and Vishambar. Bholi. Her real name is Sulekha. And she is Nambardar, Ramlal's youngest daughter. School education changes her outlook towards life. Ramlal, Bholi's father. He is a prosperous father of 7 children who has a narrow mindset. For him, daughters are born for marriage only. Bholi's mother. She is a typical conservative mother. She does not take proper care of Bholi. Bholi's school teacher. She educates Bholi and encourages her. Vishambar. Bholi's prospective husband, who is a greedy man and a dowry seeker. Now, summary of the lesson. Bholi's first few years. Bholi was one of 7 children of Ramlal. Ramlal was a well-to-do man, as he was the Nambardar of the village. There was no lack of comforts in his home, but Bholi was still neglected. She fell off her cot when she was just 10 months old. Her brain suffered some damage and she was slow in learning things. So, everyone called her Bholi. An attack of smallpox at the age of 2 years left her pockmarked on her entire body. She learned to speak when she was 5, but she stammered. Everyone made fun of her. Even her parents took her to be just an ugly burden. Bholi goes to school. Once the tehsildar came to inaugurate a new primary school in the village. He asked Ramlal to send his daughters to school. Ramlal could not say no to him. His wife objected that no one would marry the girls if they went to school. But then she felt that Bholi was ugly and it would be difficult to get her married. So they decided to send only Bholi to school. Bholi is prepared for school. Bholi was fearful of going to school at first. Then she was given new and clean clothes to wear. She was given a bath and her hair was oiled. Now she felt better. She thought of school as a nice place. All these years, no one had taken so much care of her. Bholi's first day at school. Bholi found the classroom full of girls like her. She was afraid and sat in one corner. She was attracted to the colorful pictures on the wall. She was much impressed by the realistic pictures of birds and animals. The teacher asked her name. Bholi stammered and then started crying. After the other children left, the teacher came back to her. She called her lovingly. This time, Bholi was able to speak her name better. The teacher encouraged her. She asked her to be fearless. She also told her to come to school every day. Bholi felt as if a new life was beginning for her. A match for Bholi. After a few years, Bholi's parents got a marriage proposal for her. Ramlal was not very happy. Actually, the man was a widower with grown-up children. But his wife was unconcerned. She just felt that as Bholi was so ugly, that proposal was good for her. Her father wanted to know how Bholi felt about the proposal. But her mother refused to ask Bholi about it. Bholi stands up for her rights. When the wedding was about to take place, Bishambhanath asked for 5,000 rupees to marry Bholi as she had pock marks. He also threatened to walk away from the ceremony. Ramlal was afraid of the humiliation, and so with tears in his eyes, he handed the dowry money to Bishambhar. Bishambhar proceeded to garland Bholi, but Bholi threw the garland away. She asked her father to take back the money and refused to marry the greedy coward. Everyone went away. Ramlal asked her what she would do now. She just told him she would work as a teacher in the same school where she had studied. Her education had changed her outlook.